हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। माई सेल्फ आशीष सर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ योर नाइन्थ केमिस्ट्री, दैट इज एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर एंड केमिकल बॉन्डिंग। इन अर्ली एज, इन 1780s, ए न्यू एरा ऑफ केमिस्ट्री वॉज अंसर्ड बाई द साइंटिस्ट सच एज लेवोसियर बाई मेकिंग केयरफुल क्वांटिटेटिव मेजरमेंट्स। दिस अलाउड द एक्यूरेसी ऑफ कंपोजिशन ऑफ कंपाउंड टू बी डिटरमाइंड। Within a span of 20 years, chemistry has made unimaginable advancements. In 1880, Dalton, while conducting an experiment with oxygen and carbon, noted that these two elements combined to form two different compounds. He also realized that for the same amount of carbon, one compound had exactly twice as much oxygen as the other. So Dalton formulated certain atomic theory, which is named as postulates of Dalton's atomic theory. What are they? All matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms. Atoms are indivisible particles. They cannot be created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. All atoms of a given element are identical in mass and chemical properties. Okay, next is the atoms of one element differ in mass and chemical properties from those of other elements. These are common things what you know, but as a postulate, Dalton has given the postulates of Dalton atomic theory. Compounds are formed when two or more different kinds of atoms combine in definite proportion. The relative number of and the kinds of atoms are constant in a given compound. With the passage of time and the induction of new inventions and discoveries, Dalton's atomic theory was subjected to scrutiny and modification. Certain modifications took place in the Dalton's atomic theory. The postulates are modified. So, basing on that, it became the modern atomic theory. The postulates are named as modern atomic theory. Okay. The modern atomic theory did not agree the Dalton's theory entirely, because atoms can be further subdivided. Afterwards, it is discovered that atom can be further subdivided as atom is divisible and destructible. Atoms of the same element may differ in the case of isotopes. So the term compound atom was replaced by the term molecule. Like this, there is certain modifications made by the modern atomic theory from the Dalton's atomic theory. So it doesn't match or agree with Dalton's atomic theory. So now we'll discuss what is an atom. An atom is the smallest particle which can take part in a chemical reaction. That you know that. What? An atom is the smallest particle of an element which can take part in a chemical reaction. So, atoms are the building block of all matters. Under normal conditions, the atoms of elements except those of noble gases like helium and argon are not capable of independent existence. So the noble gases, these are the gases helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon, are the noble gases because they always available in an independent state. They do not combine with other elements, atoms of the elements. But rest of the most of the atoms of the elements, they are not available in independent existence. Clear? Now we'll discuss how the atom, what are the subatomic particles, how the atom is subdivided. The subdivision of atom led to introduction of subatomic particles like electrons, protons and neutrons. The particles are called elementary fundamental particles. What they are called? Elementary fundamental particles, because these are the essential constituent of atoms. Okay, so now we'll discuss about these three fundamental subatomic particles. What are they? Electrons, protons and neutrons. Now we'll discuss about the discovery and the properties of the electron. What is an electron? We'll discuss. So in 1878, cathode rays were discovered by William Crookes. He found that when an electric discharge is passed through a tube containing a small quantity of gas at a very low pressure, rays are emitted from the negative plate, which are called as cathode. The negative plates are called as cathode. Since the rays originated from the cathode, they were called as cathode rays. Clear? In 1897, Sir J.J. Thomson, who found that these cathode rays consist of negatively charged particles, which were named as electrons. So, Sir J.J. Thomson discovered that these cathode rays are negatively charged particles and named as electrons. Clear? Now, what are the characteristics of electron? The charge of an individual electron is -1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. It is most important to remember the charge of an electron, the minimum value of smallest negative charge carried by any particle. So now it is considered as the unit negative charge, which is called electron has one unit negative charge, that is -1. Thus, the relative charge of an electron is -1. Clear? Then what is the mass of an electron? The mass of an electron is 9.107 × 10⁻²⁸ gram. This weight is expressed as atomic mass unit. Clear? So what is the mass of an electron? 9.107 × 10⁻²⁸ grams. So this is the emission of pink glow by air inside the discharge tube. This is the cathode rays discharged, and this is anode, and this is the cathode, which is the negative plate, and when it is connected to the charge to the battery, the rays are emitted. Clear? Now see how the rays are emitted from the cathode, the negative charge plate. These are the rays it is emitted, which is called cathode rays. Clear? Now, the mass of an electron is considered as atomic mass unit. What is that? 9.107 × 10⁻²⁸ gram. Clear? Which is approximately equal to 1/1837 of the weight of a hydrogen atom. Clear? Now, electron has a property, particle nature. Electron have a particle nature and never travel in a straight line. This is deduced that because a stream of electron could cast a shadow if an object was placed in their path. Suppose these are the cathode rays. If you place an object here and a screen here, you will find the shadow on the shadow of the object on this screen. So this proves that these electrons are moving in a straight line. Then electrons deflect towards a positive field and away from the negative field. Because why? Because these electrons are negatively charged, that's why they are deflected by the negative field and they are attracted towards the positive field. So what is an electron? So to define an electron is defined as a subatomic fundamental particle having a mass equal to 1/1837 of that of a hydrogen atom and carry a unit negative charge. This is the definition of an electron. So you have to remember the definition of an electron. Its charge not as a unit negative charge. What is its charge? -1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. And the mass is 9.107 × 10⁻²⁸ gram. Okay. So this is all about our discussion of electrons discovery and what is the charge and the mass. Now we'll discuss the discovery of protein. Discovery of proton. If negatively charged particles are present in an atom, positively charged particle must also be present. Because why? Because atom is electrically neutral. So how much the quantity of negative charges are there? Same quantity of positive charge must be there in an atom so that atom will be electrically neutral. Such this search for such a type of particle led to discovery of proton. This led to discovery of proton. So this discovery is credited to Eugen Goldstein, who discovered proton. In 1886, what he has done? Goldstein's work with a perforated cathode ray, cathode plate. He has done this. This is the Goldstein's discharge tube experiment producing anode rays. What happened? When anode plate is connected, it is the positively charged and it is negatively charged. Some rays are deflected like this and some is deflected like this. Okay, these are the anode rays, these are the cathode rays. Why? These are attracted towards the positively charged plates, these are the negatively charged, and these are the fluorescence is produced here. Clear? These are the anode rays. So discharge tube led to discovery of the protons. Goldstein observed that there was another set of rays traveling in a direction opposite to the cathode rays. Clear? These rays showed characteristic diametrically opposite to that of cathode rays. The properties are just opposite to that of cathode rays. Hence, it was concluded that these rays considered of positively charged particle, which are called proton. Clear? The proton was found to have a charge equal magnitude and but opposite in sign, that of electron, and a mass almost equal to mass of a hydrogen atom. So what it is detected as the total negative charge as well as the total positive charge are same. So the magnitude of each proton is almost equal to the magnitude of charge of electron, and the sign is just opposite. Clear? And the mass is equal to mass of the proton is equal to mass of hydrogen atom. But what about electron? The mass of electron is 1/1837 of mass of an atom of hydrogen. So proton are formed in discharge tube containing a little hydrogen gas. Now what are the characteristics of proton? The charge of an individual proton is same, but the sign is different. In electron it was -1.602, in proton it is +1.602 into 10 to the power -19 coulomb. So it is relatively positive charge and it is +1. The mass is equal to 1.672 into 10 to the power -24 grams, which is approximately equal to mass of a hydrogen atom. Clear? Now protons deflect towards the negative plate and away from the positive field. As it is positively charged, it deflects towards the negative plate or field and away from the positive field because of same charge and opposite charges. So the proton were believed to be situated in the central region of an atom called nucleus. What is the central region of an atom? That is nucleus. Now what is a proton? How you will define? Proton is defined as a subatomic particle having mass equal to that of a hydrogen atom, one unit, and carrying one unit of positive charge. It is the definition. Clear? But the exact charges and masses you have to remember. Now, what is the structure of an atom? We will discuss. Many models have been suggested by different scientists. J.J. Thomson has given a model of an atom. In 1898, J.J. Thomson proposed a model of the structure of an atom, how it looks like, how it is. So it is called as Thomson's plum pudding model of an atom. Thomson proposed that an atom is considered to be a sphere of uniform positive charge. It is a sphere of uniform positive charge into which the negative charged electrons are embedded. See the structure, the uniformly positive charges are there in which negatively charged particles or the electrons are embedded. Second point is the negative and positive charge are equal magnitude and the atom as a whole electrically neutral. So as the atom is electrically neutral, so he gave that in this figure the number of positive charges and number of negative charges are same. Clear? The masses of atom is considered to be eventually the evenly spread over the atom. He was telling that according to his concept, the electrons and protons are uniformly distributed throughout the atom. It is completely spread throughout the, evenly spread throughout the atom. This was the model given by Thomson. What is that called? Plum pudding model of an atom. Okay. Thank you, children. You discuss and you see the video along with your textbook. And next class we'll continue further. Thank you.